petrol companies are on notice to pass fuel savings on to motorists when Auckland's regional fuel tax is finally removed at the end of June. This as questions continue to swirl over how the government and the council will pay for big transport initiatives. Business correspondent Katie Bradford has details.
Friday afternoon, and yet again, Aucklanders are stuck in traffic. The city's fuel tax was designed to help pay for major projects and ease congestion.
Those costs will come back to Aucklanders at some point, whether it's this year or 2-3 years from now.
The government's axed the tax and is now promising to make sure the 11.5 cent saving is passed on to consumers.
We'll be making our expectations very clear.
The pressure will be on the Commerce Commission to monitor that.
I'm really sure that the fuel companies know that we're watching this, and I know that they'll be watching it themselves. And so, you know, in the event that it's an unsatisfactory pass-through, we'll have a think about what to do next. There may be some policy issues in there.
And I have a high degree of confidence that those savings will come through.
Auckland Council faces a $2 billion gap in its transport budget, but the Mayor's ruled out rates rises to fill the void.
They pay for the infrastructure, our roading, the repairs, the fixing of those potholes, the building of the bridges and the motorways.
Auckland already has cheaper fuel than some spots in Wellington, for example, and there are price fluctuations even in the same city.
You can go all different parts of Auckland and the petrol prices now can be $2.60, $2.70, $2.80 within a couple kilometres of each other.
Speaking to a business crowd, the Minister for Auckland today announced any second harbour crossing will be for cars and buses only.
This needs to be about roading resilience and improvements to the busway, and we've just outlined that we're not going to continue with planning for light rail and walking and cycling as part of that.
This councillor says the government should have kept the fuel tax in place until an alternative was found.
The biggest issue for Auckland is that we've got decades of underinvestment in infrastructure. We find it in transport and water and other areas that people are waiting for these projects, and they're only going to get more expensive, and we're still going to need to be doing that.
The axe doesn't fall on the fuel tax until the end of June.
All right, Katie, they say they're watching, but what's to stop companies simply keeping the fuel price where it is and pocketing the difference?
Kia ora, good evening. Well, there are a huge number of factors that go into the price we see at the pump. Taxes are, of course, one of those, but also, obviously, international oil prices, importer margins and so forth. And the Commerce Commission has been given powers to keep a very close eye on those fuel companies. We saw that following that fuel inquiry a few years ago. And the Commerce Commission does now release quarterly reports looking at things like the price, importer margins, where they stand, if it's reasonable. We are expecting the next one of those reports to come out shortly. But they've also been doing things like sending warnings to fuel companies when they think petrol prices are too high. We saw it a few months ago in Whangarei, for instance. The ComCom took a look at that and said, we don't see why prices are as high as they are right now. Sent warning letters to the fuel companies saying what's going on. And they said since then, they have seen prices start to fall. So the Commerce Commission says, well, look, those powers we have, that work we're doing, is working at the moment. But we will be keeping a close eye on that to make sure that happens. Minister Simeon Brown told me this afternoon that he is also seeking further advice to see if there is anything else the government can do to ensure fuel companies do pass that cost, those savings on to consumers. Consumers, of course, will also be looking, but as you heard, there's all those fluctuations we see within cities and within the country, so it is very hard for people to tell when they rock up to the petrol station if those savings are passed on. Of course, the wider issue with this whole story, as you heard in this and my story there, is that yes, people will save more money at the pump as long as that cost is passed on, but how are we going to pay for those projects in the future? One way or another, taxpayers and ratepayers will be paying for it.
Yes, indeed. Katie, thank you very much.